Thank you. Thank you. I picked the wrong tune to start to say something after. That was gorgeous. Nice work. We kind of joked in rehearsals a few times about who picks these programs anyway. as you'll see from going to that very profound piece to the next one, it'll be quite an emotional shift, shall we say. Bowdoin, as indicated by Terry's notes in your programs, Bowdoin has a deep history of being a singing college, and Terry Stenberg was very much a part of that culture back in when he was a student here in the 50s, and he felt it to be a mission that in some way that we preserve some of those old Bowdoin songs from back when it was known as the singing college. And he wrote this medley with the intent that he would have, he originally wrote it for orchestra. And so his original intent was to record it with the Portland Symphony Orchestra, a monumental task, especially given that it was his first instrumental piece that he ever wrote or arranged. And then to have it in the archives and the library so that future generations will always be able to reference those songs through time. Terry approached me when he was writing it for the Portland Symphony and asked if I would look over and offer some suggestions. And so through a series of meetings, we worked on it and did a lot of editing to the piece. And there were things that, once I found out his intent, then we were able to piece things together. And then he rented the Portland Symphony for a morning to record this piece. I won't tell you exactly how much that cost, but if you think of renting a whole orchestra, unionized orchestra that you're obligated to, I think a minimum of, it's either 3 or 4 hours that you have to rent them, times the amount of musicians, times the facility and everything. It was a major, major project for him to do. But he felt strong enough about it that that it needed to be done. And he found a way to do it, and they recorded it with the Portland Symphony. And then when they were done recording it with the Portland Symphony, I said, okay, now that you've done it for them, I said, given that I've worked with you on this, let's do it for the band. And he said, okay, how do we do that? And we had more meetings, and we figured out how that should go. We premiered this, I believe it was 2013. I could be wrong on that, but I think it was 2013. It was used for the graduating class of 2020 that had a virtual graduation ceremony. And as they scrolled the names of all the seniors, they combined some of the gym choir and chorus's previous concerts. And they included our version of this in that that graduation of sorts. Terry passed away a couple of years ago and in 2020, and I felt it fitting because we haven't had much time to do this, certainly not last year, and things got taken away from us a little bit the year before. So I didn't want to go without acknowledging what he has done for this college, and that he took something that was not a vocation of his, it was an avocation of his, and just worked his heart out to do. So in Terry's memory, we'd like to do Remembering Tilly, and you can read in your programs who Professor Tillotson was, and this marvelous medley of 5 Bowdoin songs. We will have a short 10-minute intermission. I know I've said this in the past, but please don't go anywhere because the best is yet to come in the second half. You definitely want to hang around for the harp concerto. It's just tremendous. So, one other thing. Following intermission, we will be doing 2 pieces by a Maine composer back in the late 1800s, Robert Brown Hall, R.B. Hall, who's kind of Maine's March King. He was kind of a predecessor to D'Souza. And the reason we're doing those is because Alan Grapham, who was a teacher at Mount Everett for many years, and prior to that here in Brunswick, passed away a couple years as well. And Alan used to play trumpet with us and did a lot of other things, encouraged his students to play with us, and just a whole bunch of things for us. And so we're also saluting his memory this afternoon too. He edited the two marches that were performing on the other side of intermission. So that's kind of the significance there. So we hope you'll join us after intermission for a wonderful second half. Thank you.
Thank you.
tell you how nice it is to have people in the seats. We're so used to playing to an empty hall every rehearsal, and to see all of you here is just, you know, I think for years we took it for granted, oh, we have a concert, there'll be an audience, you know, and so on. Boy, did the last 2 years kind of take that away from us, that we are not going to take that for granted anymore. I'm not, anyway. So yeah, it's great to be back. Back when we used to have people at concerts, and we used to have our concerts in here, we had a tradition for many, many, many years of acknowledging the seniors who are performing their last concert here at Bowdoin. This year it's going to be kind of a double acknowledgement, because I also want to acknowledge the seniors from 2020 who didn't, they were a month shy of playing their last concert 2 years ago. And so that's the point of the next piece. The next piece was supposed to be the last piece in their last concert, and they didn't get to do it. So we had four seniors that year, and I've invited three of them back. The reason the fourth one isn't here is because she now lives in Anchorage, Alaska. And so it was just a little too hard to get here. So I would like to call them up and acknowledge them and give them the flower. Unfortunately, I didn't hold on to the flower for 2 years. Give them wilted roses. So on flute, who, as you can see, has been playing with us this year. She works for Midcoast Hunger Prevention here in town and has not strayed too far from campus since graduating, and we're thrilled for that. And Caroline Daigle. What makes this interesting is I get to tell you what they're doing for professions now, which is never the case. But on clarinet, to us via Abbott Laboratory, she's working in the labs helping to keep us all safe and tested and you know, healthy. Danielle Horn. And the third member of the class of 2020 that's with us this afternoon, you'll hear him in a few minutes, Benny Goodman, to us via the admissions department at Dartmouth College, Ben Bousquet. Again, we have some real all-stars in this year's class. Fortunately, the good news is that we're not losing many. The bad news is the ones we're losing are really strong players, as you experienced this afternoon. So start over here on euphonium, the pride of Skowhegan. Okay. Carrie Lee. Soloist this afternoon. She's just been brilliant in her performance and has really advanced so much in the last 4 years, and you're going to be greatly missed. So thank you, Carrie. Another person that we'll truly miss in the trombone section, he's really been an anchor in the trombone section playing first trombone, and you know, I kind of, when putting this program together, I said, how can we highlight these talents? We have these euphonium solos, and I said, can I have something for trombones? And, you know, we had the marches and the Holst and all that. And he's been anchoring a large part of that. So, from Vermont, Thomas Daly. The other senior, let's see, the other senior. Oh, the harp player. On the harp from Chicago, Illinois, Josh Lynn. And thank you very much for being here. I didn't tell Josh this before we played that, but I don't know if she's still on, but the composer was told me that she'd be watching the concert. I thought I shouldn't tell him that before we played. So I feel it's safe now that I can mention that. So thank you, Heidi, if you're still watching. Marvelous piece. I hope you're pleased with the way it turned out. Again, it's so wonderful to have you here. I can't say it enough. We've been talked with some people backstage, and it's just so nice to play for faces again, even if they're best. That doesn't matter. We're playing for people, and it's just wonderful. You can't imitate that feeling when you're rehearsing. You know, and I think there was a different level of energy once we started playing at 2 o'clock, then there was at 1 o'clock when we were running through things. And it's because of you. And without you, you know, it's just not as much fun. And so thank you for being here. I hope you'll join us again next year. Hopefully we'll be indoors. Some of you remember in October we were outside in the tent. That was an experience. But again, thank you so much. Thank you to those of you who are online. We highly value your participation with us this afternoon as well. And I know there are quite a few people online. So again, thank you. Please enjoy the rest of this year, and please stay healthy out there. And we're gonna finish the program with Benny Goodman, The King of Swing, featuring Ben Goodman, who's here. Sorry, one more thing. Making her drum set debut with us this afternoon, Kay. Kay is in Grupo.